get these things fixed right here, where you're at, it doesn't matter what offense you run or what defense you run, it just doesn't matter until you get these four things fixed, in my opinion. And the first one is relationships, and that relationship is from coach to player, players to players, coaches to parents. And if you don't have that continuity in your program right there, then it's not going to work. The second deal that I talked to our players about is trust. You know, we've got to be able to trust you to take care of those grades. We've got to be able to trust you. If you have an MRR, you better, by gosh, do an MRR so you don't let your, you know, hang your kid out or hang your teammate out and let him get blown up. You know, if we ask you to get in a good fighter stance out of there at receiver, you better be in a good fighter stance. We've got to be able to trust that you're going to do the detailed things that we ask you to do every day and in the ballgame. And then it goes then back down to discipline. One of the things we do, our kids come into our locker room, we put the carpet down, we make them take their shoes off before they go in that locker room. That carpet is 8 years old, it looks as good as this carpet right here. We make them hang things up in their lockers and make sure that they're exactly where they need to be, so that it's just a little thing. But if you don't take care of those little things, then when you get into big ball games, it'll cost you. And so those are some of the things we do as far as discipline. And then the character is a big deal of mine. You know, we're in the business to make good men out of our young men. And we talk about character all the time. I want to have honest kids. I want to have respected kids. I want to have kids that are going to do right, even when no one else is looking. And so we talk a lot about that. And like I said, if you don't take care of those four things, then you're never going to be where you need to be. See what's about. I'm not sure what I'm doing. Real quick. And the other key to my success is, I'm telling you, every one of you guys in this room are definitely a lot smarter than I am, and every one of these guys that are on my staff here are smarter than I am. And I have chose well as a head coach. I have chose good men that are going to take care of kids, and I've chose smart men that are going to get the job done. And some of those guys are here. One of my guys that's already taken a head job at Junction, and they were here earlier with kind of 5-hour drive, so he's not here. But Mitch McLemore, he's my defense coordinator. Guys, I'd like y'all to stand up because I'm proud of you. So Jeremy West, he's our offense coordinator right here. Ronnie Casey here, and then Lanny Templeton, he couldn't make it today. Sean Speck, and then Webb Murphy down here at the bottom. I don't know why his name is in their case. They pointed that out to me. But I'm going to be real honest with you. When I came back from Lubbock on Friday was the first day that I had an opportunity to put a slideshow together. And I had to go to a ball game that afternoon. So I'm getting home about 9 o'clock, and I'm trying to put all this stuff together. And at 12:30, PowerPoint was kicking my butt, and I was tired. And that's probably why that is like that. And I probably have a lot of misspelled words up there because I didn't do spell check, so please don't hold that against me as well. But, well, you're not any less important than anybody else. Like I said, you've got to take care of all of those things before you're going to win championships, and we're proud of these teams. We're proud of the number of kids that we have out in our program. Numbers are a big deal to us. I probably have two guys on that team right there that I probably recruited from the halls, and they started off as water boys, and they hung around us long enough that they go, you know what, I think I want to be a part of that. And I know I've at least got one water boy in there that is now a football player. And that's a better picture, but like I said, I couldn't figure out the PowerPoint Friday night at 12:30, so it's a little blurry, but I did better on this one. This is this year's state championship team. Nobody thought we could do it the second year in a row. We all thought we could. Our kids thought they could. The only thing that kept us in the game and allowed us to win a state championship is we stayed injury free. I'm going to share some stuff with you later in this presentation that I feel like kept us healthy and allowed us to later in the season beat people because we were playing with the same kids. And that's crucial at our level when you only have so few to choose from. So that's a good-looking group of young men right there that